All right, Sumari to everybody else. Yeah, so I'm back, right? Now, yeah, yesterday we got into the... I left off on the dream language, right? And there's some nice comments coming back from the usual suspects. And you guys know who you are, but still good. Now, one of our brothers, Brother Freddy Emotep, who's on YouTube also, with his videos, dropping knowledge, and his private experiences. He made a comment, right? And I can't read it word for word because I'm on my phone recording it, so... But basically, he said that he heard the language as well, and he's not the first. I mean, like I said, I've been holding on this, off on this for years, and there have been many individuals, even over here in Japan, talking about... They've heard strange languages being spoken to them. You go on YouTube, you go on the internet, people talking about shadow people. Remember those guys? Had these shadow entities, right? And the shadow beings or shadow, whatever you want to call them, was speaking to them in a strange language. Or they had another entity speaking to them in a strange language. They couldn't understand it. And quite naturally, people, if they could have remembered some of the things, like they'll go and jump online and... Google Translate. No, I'm just kidding. But, you know, they'll try to get on the internet and type in certain words, which is natural, to see what does it mean or what the words meant. And basically, it was like, you know, the words, it was a real language, but not one based upon logic where you have this word means this word and we have a whole vocabulary. The language was basically being spoken by the entity or the individual that you met or that you felt was terrorizing you, and that was being spoken naturally from its own emotion. So basically it was conveying emotion to you verbally, because see, other entities, right, not in physical reality, they comprehend that we work off, well, most individuals here in physical reality, we work off of emotion, symbolism, things like that. So sometimes one way of communicating with you would be through trying to talk. And because it's trying to connect with you on a deep level, it may communicate with you. It sounds verbally, but it's communicating. It's usually the type of communication, right, that is really, it's speaking its emotion to you verbally. So when you get that, you will translate it into a language. You know, you'd be like, oh, this thing was trying to talk to me, and this is what the language sounded like. But it's basically just translating, it's giving you its emotion in a verbal form. And whatever you hear it as, that's the level that you are understanding it on. It could be something completely different. It could be communicating with you telepathically, and you are just translating it as verbally. But back to Freddy Imhotep, right? So he goes, yeah, I had this dream, and in the dream, there was like a door, and there was a lion and a wolf trying to get at him. And he was holding the door closed, they were trying to get in from the other side, and this woman appeared, a woman came, and she started speaking the language, and suddenly they disappeared, like they fucked off and went another way. And they came back, and she spoke the words two more times, and then he tried to copy, and he tried to remember what she said, and then he said the words himself, and then they both took off and disappeared. So this goes into, right, now we're getting back into the dream language once more. And what it is, right, is that, and I made a comment on my YouTube page with the last video, this language can be used, now I gotta say this slowly, right, because I don't want people to misinterpret or misunderstand. It can be used offensively. It can be used defensively. Meaning, if you're in a dream state, if you're in a non-physical reality and you feel that something's coming at you or something's trying to kill you or something's chasing you, you can speak the language of your soul, the language of dreams, the language of consciousness, of the universe, of God. You can speak it, and with that, with your intention mixed in, it will have, because I think I may have touched on this, I don't know, in the other videos. When you speak the language, right, it activates your soul. It's like, all right, we're in a non-physical reality, so something's coming at you. From your own normal level of consciousness in this non-physical reality, you're trying to fight this thing off and it's not working. When you speak your language, what this does is, one, on one level, it enforces your own power. Like, for example, like it activates your soul. On another level, I'm covering the camera again. I'm trying to keep noise, sorry. On another level, so it's activating your soul. That's one point. Second point, you're using the true language of the non-physical realm. So its main purpose is creativity, right? So from your standpoint, you're getting attacked by something. You start speaking this language, and if you're feeling like a badass at the time, you feel, yeah, this is working, man. I said this, you know, these words. I spoke my language, and everything disappeared, or the monster ran off, or the killer couldn't get me. So in that situation, you will see it as it was being like an offensive attack, or something was trying to get at you. You spoke the words, and it repelled them away from you, and that way it was defensive. But what's really happening, you got a secret. What's really happening is that you're altering the reality that you're in. The language itself alters you. And this is going to sound crazy, but it's like you are the language. So it's like you're speaking yourself into that existence and you're creating. So I hope I'm not going to lose you guys on this, because it gets real complex and complicated to explain sometimes verbally, because like this is not even the way it's coming out, is not even how I really want to say it, but it's tough due to language again. But as you speak the words into existence in that moment, you're actually speaking to yourself. The words are actually a part of you. The words are actually a part of the environment that you're in. And it's all connected. So, okay, let me give you guys some samples, right? Like, one time I was in this realm, and not physically, and I was practicing with the language. And I gotta tell you guys about how I got into this. But anyway, okay, I'll get to that in a minute. But yeah, so I was in this realm, and I was creating. I was playing with flowers. And this goes back to creating your own words for things. So, just for example, I was using telekinesis with one of the flowers, and I was motioning my hand around it. And then I said something like, Bushati, or something like that, you know. And when I said that, the flower, it exploded, but like in slow motion, but it held its place. And I was holding it in place with telekinesis. And then I said another word, and it's like, Sudim, like that. And then it went back together, and it came back together. So, at that moment, now, this doesn't mean you guys run out and you all start saying, Bushakti Salam, like Harry Potter or some shit. But it's like, that's what worked for me at that moment. See what I'm trying to say? Like in another experience, that same word, if I used it, would have something different. But it's not really about trying to say the same words over and over again. This is more of a spontaneous language. So it should be different all the time. See what I'm trying to say? Like, even if I said, like the message I gave yesterday, even if I said that same exact message today, if I even remember it, it would have a completely different meaning, because it's not what I was trying to convey yesterday. The message that I speak, it won't be the same message that I'm trying to convey today if I gave you another one, if it was the exact same thing. So this is not about like taking this as, oh, this is magic, and if I say Bushakti, it's going to explode everything. No. That's what worked for me at that time. That was the emotion I was feeling for this flower. At that moment, the word I felt with Shakti was what I needed to take this flower apart and hold it in place with telekinesis. And then the other word I said, it pulled it back together. Next time, it'll be something different with the same effect, but it's all gonna be based off of my own feelings and emotions at that time. Once again, you know, this is a language, but when you get to another stage, like once you leave this physical reality and you're going to be going on to other stages of reality, if you're at that level of development, you won't even be using these words. You know, this is, see, here's another point, right? The reason why we're still using language, it's like, okay, well, I'm non-physical, right? So why do I have to still use words in these other realities? You don't. And that's the next level of development. For right now, if you're new to this, this is just a way for you to practice it by using your own language. But on the deeper realms and the deeper levels of this, of understanding, it's all telepathic, again, thermal, magnetic, electromagnetic. It's all about energy. So we're not even using words when we get to these other realms. The reason it seems like we're still using words in these non-physical states, because we still are connected to physical reality. So we're still going to be influenced by language and things like that. However, because you're speaking in a more freestyle of speaking, by just saying your emotions at the time or what you feel is appropriate, you release yourself from the restrictions of language, of feeling like, oh, well, this is a cat, or this is that, and things like that. Like, it breaks you free from that, so you could be a lot more creative in these other realms. So back to Freddy Imhotep. Yeah, he witnessed for himself the power of this. And now you know, brother, if when you have these situations, if you feel something's trying to get at you, don't be afraid to use your language. Everyone's language is going to be unique, and that's what's interesting about this. Sometimes your language may sound like it's being influenced by languages that you already know. So, like, say, for example, if you speak Spanish, and you speak Japanese, and you speak Russian, your language may sound like a compilation of jumbled words resembling that language. Jane Roberts, the great Jane Roberts, right? The great Jane Roberts. I know she would hate anyone calling her that. But, you know, Jane Roberts, nice woman, originator, collaborator with the Self Material. She introduced the Sumari language way back then. Once again, Sumari language is the dream language, language of consciousness. But at the time, it was called the Sumari language back in the 60s, how she introduced it. And for her, it came out, it sounded like romance languages, like a combination of French and things like that, because this is coming from her own personal experience and what she felt, you know, at the time. So don't worry about what it sound like or things like that. The main important point, and I have to reiterate this, the main important point is not what it sounds like. It's, is this the sound that you feel at that moment and you're conveying your emotion at that moment? That's what it is. And get creative with it, man. Get creative with it, you know. But yeah, man. Now, let me get into how I came into this, right? Of course, I was introduced to it officially through the Self-Material. But before that, we've all had stories, many of us, when we were children, we would come in encounter with beings and they'll be speaking strange languages and things like that. The Self-Material basically, for me, just put me on track of understanding what it was. Instead of falling into, you know, fantasy and, oh, it's a demon, it's the devil, and all that stuff, it opened me up to other possibilities. And I like those possibilities, that it, the direction that it pointed me in. So with that, I started experimenting with this, and I can't remember now because it's been so long, you know. And at the time when I came into this stuff, like, I was still in the process of remembering what I am. So at that time, you know, I wasn't really aware of my multidimensionality on these levels. But what happened was, one night I went to bed and I wanted to cross over consciously. And I said, well, perhaps if I use this Sumari language, it will somehow affect my consciousness and my realm of thinking as I drift off to sleep. It'll help me cross over. And it did. But that was stage one, though. I didn't see this one. So you can't stop. You have to keep pushing and testing and trying things and just being creative. So that was step one. And most people would have been happy. Okay, I spoke this language. It helped me get lucid. Yay, now I could fly and have sex with everybody and things like that. But no, I didn't stop there. That was level one. Then level two was, one time I had this other experience where I was in a dream state, and these entities had me like, they had me, it was like a public pool, and they had me locked down and I couldn't move. It was like they were using telekinesis on me, which was rare, and that almost never happens. But at that time, I may have talked about this in another video, I suddenly remembered the Sumari language and I started speaking it. And it's in the form of chants. Look at some Hollywood shit, but I was chanting. I was looking at the individuals and I was speaking the language at the same time, focusing on what I wanted to do, which was to break free. And it worked. And then I started doing more things with it, and I realized this language, for some, and it also helped me expand my non-physical states. It's like, one another time, I remember I talked about in the past, but like, when you go out of body, you could feel when you're about to wake up or return to your body, right? You feel yourself being, your consciousness being pulled back, drifting back. When that happened, I started speaking my language, dream language, and then it prolonged the dream. It was funny because like the dream was shimmering, it was about to phase out like always and go back to my body, but then it restabilized. I was like, oh shit, man. So I started using it for that. Another time, I'm just giving you a lot of random things and possibilities, and you can find your own possibility. You tell me about it, you know. I have a lot of things that I do with it that I can't all get into at this point, but I'm just giving you some samples. Another time, what happened? Yeah, I was with some entity in this non-physical state, and he was trying to do something to me. You know, there's always some enemy trying to get me. They're always trying to get at me, man. They're jealous. Anyway, so in the dream, he was like some kind of monster, right? And I wasn't scared. So I was like, I tried to reason with him. You know, like, I've tried to detour from my ways of just killing things. And I said, well, look, man, we don't have to do this. Well, you know, this is a non-physical realm. We could just get to know each other. And he was insisting on trying to hurt me, right? So I was like, all right. So when he came at me, frozen with telekinesis, waved my hand, I spoke in my language, and I completely changed him from the monster he was in into this, like, short, chubby guy. He was like this short, stubby man. And he was very shocked, and he was like, well, what the hell? And the people I was with was shocked, like, whoa, you can do that? And I was like, all right, now can we sit down and have a logical, you know, like a conversation? And he was still bent on getting at me, so I got annoyed, and then old me came out. And I spoke my language again, motioned, and basically he left. He just disappeared. I wiped him out of the reality I was in. Now, where did he go? Who knows? He went somewhere, because you can't kill, once again, you can't kill any thought forms in non-physical reality. Nothing is destroyed. The energy can be transmutated. So wherever I sent it, it didn't matter where he went. That's the point. Where did he go? Did he go to purgatory? Maybe he went to hell. It's not important. The point is, I didn't want him fucking in front of me at that moment because he was annoying me. So I got rid of him and sent him away. But these are just some samples of like things, the possibilities, you know, the things you could come up with and experiment with on your own. And there's a lot more. I mean, this is just, I'm not going to go into all of them on purpose. Why? Because I don't want people copying. I don't want people saying, oh, wow, I can do that too. If you can, that's cool. But I don't want people trying to copy my experiences. If you come up with the same thing, cool. And that's good. If not, you make your own experiences. These are just some barely given samples of the possibilities. See, as a teacher, as a speaker, as a Sumari, I can't always give you all the details for the simple reason of I don't want people, individuals' experience to be pre-orchestrated, you know. You say, oh, well, you know, Seth had this happen to him, or, you know, whatever you want to call me by. And, you know, Sumari Dark Horse had this, or Seth's Dark Horse had that, and Sumari Torah had this, and I had the same experience. Like I said, if you did, good. But the main goal is, yeah, you can get some of my experiences, plus, main focus, your own experiences. And then you share them with the rest of the group. But anyway. Sorry, that hand's getting tired. Switch hands. where was I going? Right, so this language, it's very deep, it's very powerful. Now, on another level, you look at some of the older things about the language of angels and things like that, right? I can't remember right now because I don't really get it. I think John Dee. One of these guys, you know, from a couple hundred years ago, whatever, you know, they used to experiment with the... Oh, God. See, I'm so free from getting into terminology and things. Like I just flow with the energy and go my way that I forget sometimes some of the time. I had it and it popped back out. The language of angels is a specific word, Enochian. There we go. Enochian language, which I believe was created by or discovered by John Dee. But you have the language of angels, which is Enochian. Now, a lot of people during those times said, oh, you get the Enochian. You hear people, no, don't deal with that Enochian magic. It's dangerous. They're going to get you, get all that. Look, from my experience, right, the Enochian language, it is a language of angels, but it's nothing where, all right, well, what is an angel, right? We're talking about a non-physical being that has the ability to manipulate space and time, that lives outside of time and space, that has infinite power, that can manifest, can create. Well, basically, once again, we're talking about us in the non-physical. So when you talk about the Enochian language, you're really talking about the true language of God, which is the language of consciousness, which is the language of yourself. And if you use that, just like how people experimented with the Enochian magic during those days, and even now some people still follow that specific belief system, now you know that the so-called Enochian language, the language of the angels, is actually your own language, and it's the language of the soul. So once again, by using this, you can alter, and it's not, this is not only limited to physical reality, not by far, not by a long shot. I mean, you can use this in the physical realm as well. But once again, I want you to find your way on how you can use it. Just brief samples. You can use it to motivate yourself. You can use it when you're feeling weak or you're feeling negative, you're feeling depressed. You can speak your language. Sometimes when you're pissed off and you talk to these, oh, that bitch, motherfucker, oh, I'm tired of shit. You know, when you get into that phase, sometimes you get so angry, like you find yourself speaking gibberish or what could be called speaking in tongues. Like you're so angry, it's just coming out like that, motherfucker, things like that. But really what that is that at that moment, your emotions are overriding logical thinking. Your emotions are overriding speech, verbal speech. And you're so hot right now, your emotions are running so high that your soul language, your dream language, your language of God, your whatever you want to call it, it's coming out, or it's trying to come out. But then you restrict yourself. You're like, oh, that, okay, let me stay calm. Yeah, I'm getting upset. No, let it free, man, let it out. You know, this is the real you. This is the real communication that you're trying to deal with. But yeah, so yeah, we got that. And it's cold. It is cold, man, it's cold. But I mean, this goes deep. If you want to know more about it, of course, you can go to Seth Material, look it up. This is, like, none of this stuff is new. You know, I'm not the first person to come out with this. This is not new, and there's not a new discovery by me. I'm just one of many, of an infinite number of others that has become aware of it. That's it. And if you want to, you know, that's why I recommend, yeah, go read the books if you want. And, you know, you can find out more and make your own interpretations of it. If you don't want to read the books, fine. You don't have to read the books. Now you know about it. And you know what to do with it and how to use it. Touching back, I was talking yesterday about where does information come from, right? And I wanted to get more deeper into that. Because, you know, I'd be forgetting sometimes. But it was like, what I was trying to say was that all information, where does it come from? I said, it doesn't just manifest out of nowhere, or does it? And the point I was trying to go with that, the direction was, everyone's information, the people we put up is great, all the great speakers, all the great Egyptians, all the great, the wise ones, you know. But where was their information coming from? And the point is, there's only two choices, right? And the two choices are this. Either A, it was actually coming from another force outside of physical reality, higher realms of thinking, realms where thinking are actually manifest. God, if you want to call it that, or they're just making shit up based off of, maybe they're just trying to control the populace, control the people, or it was from their own private subjective experiences. With that being said, you can't deny your own experiences. If you feel you have something to share, if you feel you've made a discovery, relish in it, man, go with it. Is yours. You created it. You found it. You made the discovery. The worst thing is for an individual to come up with something and then somebody tell them, oh no, that's not how it is. You're wrong because this is how it is on this side. And then you listen to them and you never get back on it. You just cut out your own creativity from making, which could be one of the biggest discoveries ever, and you completely lose it because you're going by what somebody else is saying. So yeah, man. You know, you come up with your own things and you play around with it. It's all about play and exploration. Play and exploration and helping others at the same time, which is what these videos are doing, you know? I wasn't trying to be negative the other day when I was like, I don't have to make a fucking video. I didn't say that. I was like, you know, I didn't have to make these videos, which is true. No one has to make anything. You don't have to do anything. No one's obligated to do anything. But at the same time, I'm a speaker, I'm a Sumari, you know, and I'm a multidimensional being. Beyond all that, beyond being a Sumari, beyond being a multidimensional, beyond being a speaker and beyond being a Sumari, I'm a multidimensional being first, before even all of that. Even though I like to go, my name's Sumari Dark Arts, and I call myself Seth at times, and other people like calling me Seth, before all that, and this is for you too, we're multidimensional beings with infinite power. All those other things come secondary, but you know, I want to help other people, the individuals and stuff, by putting this information out here. And you know, a lot of this stuff, it comes from my own experience. For people who go, oh, well, you're just saying shit, you know, from the Seth books. You're copying stuff from Seth. That's a whole nother subject, man, because I gotta start walking back. Same as yesterday, I'm gonna walk the streets, look like a raging psycho to the people of Japan. That's a little song. Try to copy that, man. Shit. New debut album. Anyway, yeah, I'm walking. Oh, shit. I left a towel behind. Oh, no, man. DNA. They're gonna try to clone me. All right. Anyway, so I'm recording now. I'm walking. There's people looking. So now, back to my point. What was my point? I laugh a lot. I feel crazy. Yeah. So you're gonna make your own discoveries, right? And all knowledge is coming from somewhere. Where's it coming from? Like I said, it's either A, made up bullshit that people just put out there, or second, it's more of, it's coming from higher realms of thinking. And you have to take this into consideration, right? If you're gonna say that you believe in God, right? This is for anybody. If you believe in God, if you believe in a higher force, a higher power, whatever you wanna call it, if you're going to believe that, then you must take into consideration that there's gonna be other individuals in your realm of reality that also can come up with this information. If you're gonna say that this person was great, the wise ones, the Buddha, all these characters, you have to think that that has not stopped. You know, the 12 apostles, Buddha, you know, Vishnu, all these people, they were not the only ones at those times. You have one story out of infinite number of others that was going on at the time in those realities at their moment point in existence. And you take that and you say, oh, well, this was a great person at that time. There were others, but many of them go unnoticed, just like now, these days. There's people with the same information as me, people with the same information as the 12 apostles, people with the same information of all the ones that you consider great in existing at all times on the planet. They're just so spread out that you're not really, you know, we don't know about them. You know, they might not have internet. They might be off in a poor village somewhere. They might not even want to be known. They might just keep the information to themselves and say, fuck everybody, you know, this is great information. I'm gonna keep it for myself. I don't want to share it. There might be others who decide that, you know, maybe I'll make a video one day if I have time. Well, that's what it all comes down to, you know. So yeah, all the information is coming from different places, you know. It's all coming from somewhere. But the main question is where. And this is where you have to meditate on. It's like, you have to think, you are great also. You also have the ability to come up with, all the things I'm coming up with is, one, mostly my own experience. Two, yes, the Seth material helped me remember at a faster rate. And that's what the purpose of it is. Helps you to remember what you are. You know, get back on track. And you remember what you are, and you accelerate. But you guys know when I'm walking, like, my mind, because I gotta keep aware of what's going on. Make sure I get hit by a bus and shit. You know? I don't wanna be on the news, you know. A young man gets killed by a bus while holding iPhone, playing Pokemon Go or some shit. That's what they'll say. But, so yeah, I'm in Japan. Give you a look at that. You see that? Yeah, that's what it looks like out here. But I hope I gave you guys like enough information about the Sumari language, dream language. Don't get caught up by names. One level it's called the Sumari language, another person will call it Enochian. I'm just going by what I feel comfortable with. But yeah, these are things that we need to get into, people. I told you guys I was gonna take it up a notch, and as I said before, some people got it, some people didn't get it. Some people might just disappear, some people will comment, some people won't comment, you know, that's what it's about. But, okay, exercise time. Give you guys an exercise. This is going to be an exercise in creativity. And basically, this is what I want you to do. A lot of, you know, I was looking at TV the other day and I got pissed off because I was like, some guy was playing an instrument. It was like a group, they were playing something. And, you know, I'm not bashing people, but it's like, come on, man. We've been on the planet for this long. Nobody should be copying other people's fucking music and stuff, man. Like, make something original, man. Like, why are we, every time you look at a musician or some people on TV, some corporate control entity show, you know, they're singing somebody else's shit, man. You know, there's Who Wants to Be a Superstar and all that stuff. You know, if you want to see people's real talent, give them the chance to do their own shit. Let them play their own music. Let them make their own song. Why they got to sing somebody else's shit as a cover? You know, so what? That doesn't impress me that you could sing someone else's song very nice. Yeah, you got a nice voice, but, you know, it's like, so what? You know? Now, if you make your own stuff, that's cool. So, I got to get back. So, the exercise is, I want you to go into your meditation pose or whatever you're going to do. Oh, meditation pose. Get into your, whatever you do to get into your non-physical state. And I want you to try to create something new. Think of a new reality. Think of, if you play music, think of a new song. Create something that has, I want you to try to create something out of nothing. Try to create something that completely doesn't exist, you know, at all in another realm of reality. Hey man, what's up? Good. Thank you, thank you. I gotta get to class now. I get back, now I'm doing a recording. But yeah, that's your exercise. You make something up for another level of reality. It could be music, it could be an idea, whatever it is, and try to come up with something that does not exist already. That's your homework. Get back at you guys. Smart to everybody out there. Talk to you later. Bye.